Frankie at...
So here's the former UFC lightweight champion, Frankie Edgar, beat BJ Penn to win the belt back in 2010. Competed at featherweight for a while as well, but this was really a guy, DC, who popularized competing at the natural weight before it became all the rage.
Yeah, he just didn't want to cut weight. He told me also that because his kid wrestles, he won't make his kid cut weight because he doesn't cut weight. Why should he make him do something he won't do? But he fought where he felt most comfortable. He was not draining himself. And by not draining yourself to get on the scale, Frankie was able to fight with a pace that a lot of those 155-pound guys could not match. Frankie's a phenomenal wrestler, wrestled at the Clarion University, coached at Rutgers University, but has developed striking under Mark Henry that is as good as anybody in the organization.
And when you bury him, what does he do? He comes back and shows you a vintage performance, got knocked out by Brian Ortega, came back to dominate Cub Swanson just about 6 weeks later. Frankie Edgar back on the proven ground here tonight. Well, we probably trot out the term well-rounded in modern-day mixed martial arts more than we should, but this fighter certainly fits the bill.
Oh, 110%. He can do everything inside the octagon. Where he is most comfortable is inside of that eight-sided structure where most men are terrified of being. But for this gentleman, he only wants to be there. When you try to wrestle him, he's able to defend takedowns. If you dare stand and strike with him, he can knock you out. He's got all the tools necessary to become a UFC champion.
His first martial art, mixed martial arts. And that's not always the case. He believes that he should have a lot of advantages in this matchup tonight.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is three rounds in the UFC bantamweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a wrestler holding a professional record of 23 wins, 11 losses, and one draw. He stands 5'6" tall, weighing in at 135 pounds. Fighting out of Toms River, New Jersey, Frankie the S.I. And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a mixed martial artist holding a professional record of 20 wins, 12 losses, and one draw. He stands 5'7" tall, weighing in at 135 pounds. Fighting out of Lee Summit, Missouri, Tim Elliott. And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the octagon is Dan Mergliotta.
Dan Mergliotta.
Are you ready?
All right, so here we go. Round one is underway. And when we sat down with him on Thursday, he understood the grappling challenge he was up against. He's not afraid to engage on the ground.
It's a danger that is not worth risking. It is something that you don't want to play with. This grappler is that good. When this fight gets to the ground, you enter his world, especially when it looks like you hold the advantage on the feet.
Edgar gets caught with that punch. Not the easiest guy in the world to hit, but he got caught there. Tries to mix in a takedown here. Single collar tie now.
Defense on the takedown and scrambles to his feet. Nicely done.
Well, perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands a kick there.
Nice kick landed by this gentleman.
Oh, single collar tie here.
When you're in a clinch, you can pull down on the head and land a beautiful punch to the head.
Double leg takedown attempt here, and that one is true. Nice job there to enter and ultimately plant his opponent on the mat.
Now what does he do? That he's gotten his best shot off, finished the attack. Where does he go now from the top position?
Oh, big combination of ground and pound strikes here, DC. This could be the beginning of the end.
I mean, you got to be very careful when you take these big ground and pound strikes. You need a controlled posture on the bottom. And if you're the top guy, the guy that's looking to finish, continue to gain posture and rain down big strikes on your opponent.
Crazy accuracy and efficiency with these ground and pound strikes here. And if you're the opponent, you've got to intelligently defend or the referee's going to stop.
You've got to defend, but you can see
looks like he's transitioned to an armbar.
You cannot stay in the guard of these great jiu-jitsu guys. An attack, an armbar. You gotta recognize that when a guy starts to put his feet on your hips, you gotta move him off, and you gotta cover. You can't be off to an angle.
This might just be a matter of time. He finishes his opponent by way of submission. Quite a wild round and a wild sequence there on the ground, DC. Talk us through the highlight.
He's such a phenomenal grappler. I don't understand how people don't know that this guy wants to submit you. He is the best grappler, best submission specialist we've seen in a long time.
So there he is, your winner by submission, and that's exactly how you put the rest of this division on notice. Looks like this guy could be a factor moving forward in this division.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Bergliotta calls a stop to this contest at 3 minutes, 48 seconds of the very first round. Declaring the winner by tap out, Frankie the Answer Edgar!
All right, so there he is, all smiles, and rightfully so, after he gets the job done by submission tonight. You told me off the air before the fight that he was going to submit him, and that's exactly what happened, man.
I mean, you know, this guy has such a great submission game that you cannot lay in his guard. And his opponent is known to lay in the guard. He made him pay for it tonight and got the submission victory.